Welcome, everybody, to Ann Arbor, Michigan, where today the Wolverines host the Nebraska Cornhuskers. The Wolverines looking to rebound from a pummeling last week at Michigan State. While the Cornhuskers are still riding high after last week's improbable win against Northwestern.
Final play of the game. Launches the throw down toward the goal line, going up. Ball tipped in the air.
Touchdown, Jordan Westerkamp. Nebraska wins the game on the final play of the contest.
Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! What a scene in Lincoln, baby!
Nebraska wins the game 27-24.
Welcome, everybody, to ESPN on ABC College Football, presented by K Jewelers. Today, two of the four winningest programs in the history of major college football go head-to-head. And though the Huskers and Wolverines come into this one with differing emotions after last weekend's game, they have the identical overall record of 6-2. Nebraska still in control of its own destiny in the Legends division of the Big Ten. They're a game behind Michigan State, but Nebraska hosts the Spartans next week, and a win today would set up a major showdown in Lincoln next Saturday. Michigan has very faint hopes of playing for the Big Ten title. Hi, everybody, and welcome. Sean McDonough along with Chris Spielman. We'll be joined in a moment by Shannon Spake. Delighted to have you with us. The Michigan Wolverines trying to bounce back. They got hammered up the road last weekend in East Lansing. Did not score a touchdown in that game, Chris. A school record low, minus 48 yards of rushing. Seven times Devin Gardner was sacked.
Yeah, and he got hit 27 times. And Devin Gardner's a good quarterback, Sean. He's learned to protect the football. The problem that Devin is having is his pass protection. Last week against Michigan State, you talked about the seven sacks and 27 hits. Here's where the problem is. When any line runs a stunt, and this stunt is called a twist or a barrel or an X game, their young offensive line, especially from guard, center, guard, has trouble picking that up. The other issue with pass protection is Fitzgerald Toussaint. He's not a good pass protector. It's not lack of effort. It's not toughness. He just gets overmatched. They have to get that corrected because I expect Nebraska give them a heavy dose of stunts up front this week when they play Michigan.
And Michigan will probably try to establish the run today against the Nebraska defense that has had difficulty many times this year stopping the run. Nebraska laid it off that dramatic win last week at home against Northwestern. They're 4-0 now under the starting quarterback Tommy Armstrong, in for the injured Taylor Martinez.
Well, he's a good young player. He makes some poor decisions throwing the football. But in order for Nebraska to be effective offensively, he has to manage the game, cut down on the turnovers. Also, he needs help from Amir Abdullah. They have to get their ground game going. Last week against Northwestern, they had a combined 41 carries. Sean, I think they need at least 40 carries today to have a chance against Michigan.
Nebraska and Michigan, and the kickoff from Ann Arbor right after this. We're back at the Big House in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Comfortably warm day for November, 55 degrees, but the wind could be a factor. Out of the southwest at 16 miles per hour, that'll be right to left as you look down from our game camera for most of our coverage today. Down on the field, here's Shannon Spake.
Well, Sean, you guys already mentioned some of the struggles that the Michigan offensive line has been having, but in fact, it's a Nebraska entire offense that, according to coordinator Tim Beck, is, quote, limping into this game. Significant injuries, starting with, of course, their starting quarterback Taylor Martinez. Also out for today's game, wide receiver Jamal Turner, guards Spencer Long and Jake Cotton. Now, wide receiver Kenny Bell and tight end Jake Long are here and will play, but both are still nursing injuries. Now, Nebraska will have two quarterbacks here today. They will both play, Tommy Armstrong Jr. and Mr. Hail Mary, Ronnie Kellogg III. One thing to watch, you mentioned the wind. I checked in with the team. They told me that because Tommy Armstrong has a slight vertical angle on his passes, sometimes the wind will challenge him. Something to watch for.
All right, Shannon, thank you very much. Gives you a good idea of the breeze. Michigan won the toss and deferred. So Brady Hoke's Wolverines will kick off. He's undefeated as head coach at Michigan here at the Big House, 19-0. That's the longest active home winning streak among schools in BCS automatic qualifying conferences. And Bo Pelini in his sixth year at Nebraska won more than 71% of his games, but he's come under some fire this year despite winning at least 9 games in each of his first 5 years at Nebraska. I think that win last week was big for him in a lot of ways.
Big relief for Bo and Nebraska. And it's funny, Sean, we're both teams are 6-2, and we're reading articles all week about how both coaches are under a little bit of fire. But that's when you coach in Nebraska or you coach in Michigan, you expect that.
Well, Nebraska, the fourth winningest program of all time. Michigan is number one with 909 all-time victories. So 6-2 and not ranked is not satisfying for these fan bases and for the players and coaches as well. They expect to be better. Well, Nebraska will be going into that stiff wind in the first quarter. Matt Weil will kick off. And already the wind poses a problem as the ball blows off the tee for the junior from San Diego. Strong leg, about half his kickoffs this year have gone for touchbacks, 28 out of 55. And he is a Michigan man, as they like to say around here. His father, grandfather, great-grandfather, great-great-grandfather all went to Michigan Medical School. And they're underway. And Amir Abdullah will take a knee in the middle of the end zone. So Tommy Armstrong makes his fifth career start, the redshirt freshman from Cibolo, Texas. Community of about 18,000. He told us yesterday it's between San Antonio and Austin. And a dual threat. He can run in addition to his passing prowess. Threw for 173 and a touchdown last week in the win against the Northwestern Wildcats, and also ran for 69. They start in the pistol with their leading rusher Abdullah, and he gets nothing. Tackled at the line by Cam Gordon, one of the 4 team captains for the University of Michigan.
You look at Tommy Armstrong, he's developing as a player. I think he's going to be very good. He just has trouble reading coverages and sometimes makes the mistake of throwing into coverages.
He's thrown 3 interceptions in each of the last 2 games. Matter of fact, last week against Northwestern, 3 of his last 8 passes were intercepted. The defense bailed him out a couple of times to set up the game-winning Hail Mary. Keeps it on the option, might have been a mistake. He's taken down by Jabril Black.
This is a good job by Gordon, kind of playing both guys, a quarterback and a running back, and a good decision by Armstrong, because if he pitched that, I'm not sure that wouldn't be deflected.
Third down and 15 for the Huskers, 46% for the year on third down. Armstrong against the 4-man rush, steps up and throws to Jordan Westerkamp for a first down. Last week's co-hero along with Ron Kellogg III with a nice catch and a gain of 26.
Linebackers have to know the sticks. It's third and 15. If there's no threat in front of you like there wasn't for Bolden, you have to keep getting depth and take away the middle of the field because your safeties are bailing out.
If the coaches were worried about Armstrong's throws into the breeze, that was a good one. Out of the pistol again. Abdullah, a little more running room. He crosses into Wolverine territory to the 48-yard line. Desmond Morgan made the tackle. Let's look at today's impact players brought to you by Chick-fil-A.
Well, we talked about Abdullah, Sean. Could he play at the next level? I think he can. Kenny Bell, consistent wide receiver, and of course the big tall target coming off a career-high 6 receptions, Quinson Enunwa.
Deep throw intended for Kenny Bell, who played just the opening minutes last week against Northwestern and then left. Been bothered by a groin problem and a shoulder injury. He was in and out of practice this week. Second leading receiver behind big Quincy Enunwa. Third down and 6.
Michigan brings a blitz, and they get to Armstrong. Hit as he throws, and it's too long. We talked about the problems up front on offense for Michigan, but it's a patchwork offensive line for Nebraska as well due to injuries.
Yeah, right there, Blake Count is coming from the nickel position, and Abdullah missed him. That's Abdullah's pickup. He's going to chip on Desmond Morgan and help his guard, but he missed the blitzing nickel, which caused an overthrow by Armstrong.
Sam Foltz, freshman from Grand Island, Nebraska, on the punt. An inconsistent year. That's off the side of his foot and out of bounds, angling for the corner. He would have liked it to have traveled a bit deeper. I'm going to mark it right at the 20-yard line. Well, that's where Devin Gardner and the Wolverines take over after a 29-yard punt. Fourth-year junior from Detroit, out of Inkster High School, between Detroit and here in Ann Arbor. 60% completions, but the ratio not good. 13 touchdowns to 11 interceptions. Not good, although he has cut down on the interceptions in the last few weeks. He was under siege throughout last Saturday's game at Michigan State. Fitzgerald Tucson taken down for a loss by David Santos, the Buck linebacker, outside linebacker.
Look at Michigan, Sean. They have to be effective running the football. You mentioned a career minus 48 for a record for Michigan in yardage. And they believe that they can attack Nebraska in that middle, in between the tackles. And they have to get Tucson going. If he's not going, then look for the true freshman coming in Derek Green, number 27.
Michigan has not been a great rushing team. 10th in the Big Ten with 155 yards per game. Gardner kept, and then he got sent back by Corey Cooper, who came into today's game tied with Santos for the team lead in tackles, and they've each had a tackle on two plays.
Well, I think Nebraska is expecting Michigan to run the middle. That's why you have a safety making a tackle 2 yards past the line of scrimmage. Outstanding job by Cooper reading it and cutting back and filling his lane.
Al Borges, the offensive coordinator for Michigan, told us yesterday that their video people put together a tape of runs of 4 yards or more against the defense that they're playing from the entire season. And most of the runs of 4 yards or more against Nebraska's defense came between the tackles. The Huskers blitz off his back foot. Gardner throws a flutter ball incomplete in the direction of Devin Funchess. With Stanley Jean Baptiste in coverage, so a three and out for the Wolverines.
That's a matchup to watch all day. I love Funchess. I think he's a big target at tight end, but he can move out and play the slot receiver against a very big corner and a good corner in Stanley Jean Baptiste.
Matt Weil should be able to hammer one with the wind. Jordan Westerkamp is at his own 30. That's 50 yards away from the line of scrimmage as he goes back to field the punt. Westerkamp caught it on the run. Made the first man miss. And a good return by Westerkamp into Michigan territory. The Huskers have been one of the worst punt return teams in the country, averaging less than 3.5 yards per return. That one went for 17.
This telecast is available in high definition. Brought to you by Vizio.
Back at Michigan Stadium in Ann Arbor, no score. Nebraska and Michigan, the opening moments. By going into a strong wind, the field position in favor of Nebraska. Devin Gardner, his mates, talk about the three and out to start the game. Apparently not too beat up about it. Some laughter and smiles. Out of the pistol, Abdullah, nice hole running left. He got six, and we send you back to Robert Flores for a studio update.
All right, guys, Taco Bell studio update. Wisconsin stepping outside of Big Ten play to take on BYU at home. This is James White, 4-yard touchdown. Badgers have won 28 straight non-conference games at home.
Quick toss here to Kenny Bell, and he has a first down for Nebraska, shoved out by Blake Countess along the near sideline, the Michigan sideline. Nebraska went to the line very quickly, and it's a first down.
I love the fact that that's to get, I believe, Armstrong into some type of rhythm, eliminate the thought, and eliminating Michigan trying to change or show different looks in coverage.
Monty Cross is committed running back now for Nebraska. Armstrong took the shotgun snap. Ross, powerfully built 225-pounder, tackled by James Ross III, but it's a gain of seven.
Early on, Sean, it looks like Nebraska's offensive line, their bigs are pushing the Michigan bigs around a little bit.
They've had to move people around. You see 71 Jeremiah Searles at right tackle. He's usually the left tackle. Andrew Rodriguez, 63, is the right guard today. He's usually the right tackle. Cole Pensick at his usual center spot. The throw and the catch made. No, it skipped into Alonzo Moore with Ramon Taylor, the leading tackler for the year for Michigan, in coverage.
Not a bad throw, though. A little bit behind, but on time, just a little low. And quite frankly, you got to be able to catch that ball. That's a good ball and a blown opportunity in the red zone. You have to make those plays to give yourself a chance.
Well, we're seeing more time the last couple of weeks with the injuries to Kenny Bell. Third down and three. Night before down territory. Going into the wind here. It'd be about a 48-yard field goal. The pitch to Abdullah with some running room. Inside the 15 and down to the 12. Tackled by Blake Countess. A gain of 18 and a first down.
Another good read on the option right here. Gordon this time does not play both. He comes and attacks Armstrong. An outstanding read by Armstrong to pitch to space to Abdullah, who knows what to do with it when he gets it.
Abdullah running off left guard. Mike Mouty's the left guard today. He's ordinarily the right guard. He's moved over to the left without Jake Cotton in action today. Ordinarily the starting left guard. He's out with a knee injury. And you see that now they're shifting along the line again.
A little unbalanced. Got a pull coming from Rodriguez.
Abdul, a powerful run. He's just 5'9", but he's a very solid 190. And he can deliver a blow. He was tackled by Courtney Avery. Fastest to 1,000 yards. First to do it in eight games or fewer in Nebraska in a season since Amon Green in 1997. Here's another third and three. But Amani Cross, the running back now. The redshirt freshman, Tommy Armstrong, very poised in the big house to this point. Cross is not going to get there. Got a yard and that's all. It's fourth and two and a quick decision made by Bo Pelini. He'll send the field goal unit up for a chip shot.
Yeah, I like the decision. I think if it was one, maybe at 1.5 yards, you might go for it. But anytime you're on the road early in the ballgame, you got a chance to get points, you get them.
They'll kick a lot of field goals, as you can see. They've tried seven by Pat Smith. He's made six, and his only miss was last week, a 48-yarder to hit the right upright. This is a 21-yarder, essentially an extra point. Sam Foltz, the punter, is the holder. Gabriel Miller, the snapper. And the kick is good. 8:09 remaining in the first quarter. The Huskers on the road, leading Michigan 3-0.
ABC College Football presented by K Jewelers. K Jewelers, every kiss begins with K. Dr. Pepper 10, the manliest low-calorie soda in the history of mankind. And Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Tell you what else is pretty manly, flying in with a parachute to this stadium with the gusty wind here today. Veterans Day weekend and the University of Michigan paying tribute to veterans and active members of the military. And we add our thanks for the distinguished service of so many.
Absolutely. And that parachute guy, he was coming in hot.
I mean,
real hot.
We have no sky cam here today because they wanted to make sure there was a clear path for them to come into the stadium. Mauro Bondi has a strong leg, but he's kicking into that gusty breeze. Wow.
It doesn't matter, huh?
Wow. How about that kick? Bo Pelini was raving about his leg. 36 of his 54 kickoffs this year have gone for touchback, so he's a weapon out of Boca Raton, Florida. First down defense has been a problem all year for Nebraska. The numbers are ugly, including that bottom number. 30% of the time the opponents get another first down when they run a play on first down. There are 123 teams in the FBS this year. So when you're 119th, 117th, as they are in yards per play, 117th, giving up 7.4 yards per first down play when they're on defense. We expect them to be more aggressive on defense on first down today. Gardner in trouble, and he is taken down back at the 15-yard line. Zaire Anderson, after Aaron Curry made the initial contact.
We talked about it in the open, Sean. Fitzgerald Toussaint has trouble. You see number 28. Anderson's just going to come in and basically throw him aside, getting in Gardner's face, and is able to finish. Now, the coverage isn't bad downfield, although Jake Butt did have his guy beat. But until they get the correction of Toussaint in his pass pro, they're going to be in trouble.
Good first down defense there for Nebraska. Loss of 10. And here comes pressure off the corner, and they get there. The handoff went to Toussaint. And Leroy Alexander, extra safety, is in the game, coming off the corner. And they gave Michigan a big problem last year in that game in Lincoln, bringing players off the corner who basically went untouched by the Michigan offense. Michigan did not score a touchdown against Nebraska last year, kicked three field goals in the Husker win.
And they do have trouble handling pressure. I wonder if they're reeling still from last week and all the pressure that Michigan State brought. Is that still causing them problems?
And so much focus here all year long. Here comes another blitz, and Gardner is in trouble again. Stayed on his feet for a while, and finally yanked down by Thad Randall. We got the fans now booing the play of this offensive line as they struggle again.
A little bit's on Gardner now. He's got to read blitz, and they got to have a sight of adjustment or hot read. Here comes Toussaint again, missing Gregory and forcing Gardner to step up where Thad Randall's able to finish. They got to make an adjustment, Sean, with Toussaint. He's having difficulty picking up ball blitzes. Not because of talent, it's effort. He's not executing and getting it done. You got to adjust.
Saw the medical staff looking at Jordan Westerkamp a moment ago, and he's not back for the punt. Terrell Newby's back for the kick from Matt Weil. Plenty of room to return it. For Newby. All kinds of flags down as he goes down to the 45-yard line of Michigan. John O'Neill is the referee. 51-yard punt, 11-yard return. But the penalty to come.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Number 23, return team. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down. Timeout.
Daniel Davey called for the illegal block. He'll move the ball back to the Nebraska 44. The Huskers fired up early and leading 3-0. Back in Ann Arbor, Michigan, Nebraska leads 3-0. Michigan's had the ball twice. They've had 2 3 and outs. They have minus 19 yards of offense. The offensive line struggles continue. Taylor Lewan's number 77. All-American tackle last year. Would have been a high draft choice. Elected to come back for his senior season. This is not what he had in mind. He's done his part, according to coaches, to try to coach up the young offensive lineman around him.
He's having a good year, Sean. What they need to do is get a back in there that can protect against the blitz, and they also need to sight adjust or have hot routes run by their wide receivers to give Gardner a place to throw the football off the blitz.
Tommy Armstrong hands it off to Amir Abdullah on first and 10 for the Huskers from the 44. Nothing doing for Abdullah. Michigan coaches, Brady Hoke, the head coach, and Al Borges said that Lewan's had a better year individually than a year ago, but so much youth at the two guard spots and at the center position. They believe Lewan and Michael Schofield, the right tackle, have long NFL careers.
I will concur with that. Both of them are very good, big, talented, and good feet.
Armstrong keeps, runs through two Michigan defenders and has a first down in the Wolverine territory just inside the 45-yard line. Cam Gordon made the tackle, a gain of 12.
Perfect example of the right defense and poor execution. You have Gordon or Armstrong in your sights, you can't bring him down. He's a powerful runner.
Desmond Morgan missed him. Armstrong throws on the run. And Quincy Anunua, nice catch. Falling down, it's an 8-yard gain. Looks like they're playing again. Well, now Kenny Bell is back on the field. We haven't seen Jordan Westerkamp back. Kenny Bell back on the field for Nebraska, wide to the left. The pistol now on second and two. Abdullah carries for the first down. One of the things we noticed on the film watching Armstrong, Chris, he's very poised and very confident. This is just his fifth start. He's on the road in the biggest stadium in college football. And it doesn't look like anything's bothering him right now.
You know, I think the coaches have confidence in him when we talk to the coaches. The other thing I like, he takes control of that huddle, and he's not afraid to jump people like he did last week when they gave up a sack against Northwestern. He got on that offensive line.
They're on the move again to the Michigan 35 and out of the pistol, a play fake. Single coverage down the far sideline for Kenny Bell, and it's incomplete with Ramon Taylor running with him.
Sometimes, Sean, you throw it away. It's a good decision. Outstanding coverage by Taylor, looking and leaning, forcing Bell to the outside. He had the safety coming from the far side, so you want to make sure he doesn't have a shot to knock it or get it down.
Second and 10 with 4:02 to go in the first quarter. Michigan crowded the line. Abdullah stumbled as he caught the pitch, but stayed on his feet and has a first down. Out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Jared Wilson and Josh Furman combined on the stop at the 12-yard pickup.
It's a perfect way to attack an eight-man front when you said they're loaded up inside correctly. So you hit them with the option, and you're getting a hat on Michigan's edge players with the wide receivers of Nebraska. A great call by Tim Beck.
Nice block by Sam Birch, one of those wide receivers. Mir Abdullah has talked a lot about how outstanding the wide receivers are blocking to help him put up the big numbers in the run game. C.J. Zimmer is the fullback leading the way. Armstrong a yard, and here's Shannon Spate.
Well, Sean, wide receiver Jordan Westerkamp, he got a little banged up on that punt return, came over to the side. He was holding his right hip. They brought him into the locker room for a little bit. Now, Nebraska does not release injury information, but what I'm seeing him do is basically pace up and down the sideline, kind of nursing that right area. You can see he's in a little bit of pain, but he's still walking around.
On second and nine, play fake to Abdullah. The throw down the middle intended for Birch is incomplete, but there's a flag down. Josh Furman defending for the Wolverines.
When you're able to run the ball, you're starting to set up your play action and attack the middle of the field where their linebackers are supposed to cover. I did think he got there a little bit early.
Pass interference. Defense number 14. Ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Spot of the fouls, the 8-yard line, first and goal for Nebraska. Yeah, he's there early.
Yep, good call by the officials.
No question about it. Penalty cost the Wolverines 13 yards. Out of the pistol, Tommy Armstrong in front of Amir Abdullah. Abdullah, down to the goal line, touchdown, Cornhuskers.
What a surge by the offensive line. Take a look at Rodriguez, number 63, 71, Searles, hat on a hat, they're downfield. Pelini, number 56, with the block, and Abdullah, once he gets into that scoring territory, he knows what to do, powerful, competitive runner. Nebraska's taking the fight right to Michigan.
Doesn't look like the Wolverines have recovered from the beating they took last year at Michigan, last week, I should say, at Michigan State. Seventh rushing touchdown of the year for Amir Abdullah, the junior from Birmingham, Alabama. And Pat Smith adds the extra point. They went 56 yards in 8 plays. It took 3 minutes, and Abdullah finished the job. Tonight on ABC's Saturday Night Football, the Notre Dame Fighting Irish trying to keep their BCS bowl hopes alive. They head into Pittsburgh to Heinz Field to take on the Pitt Panthers. Notre Dame ranked number 23. Saturday Night Football presented by the new windows tonight at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC. So today on ABC, you're seeing 3 of the top 4 winningest programs of all time. Michigan number 1, Nebraska number 4 all time in wins, Notre Dame's 3rd. Dennis Northfleet back for the kickoff from Mauro Bundy.
Herbie put me on upset alert on that Pittsburgh-Nebraska game. No, I like Notre Dame. Yeah, thank you.
Well, Notre Dame has just been squeaking by. They've won 4 in a row since they lost to Oklahoma, but 3 of the 4 wins have been by 4 points or less. Amir Abdullah's touchdown has made it 10-0. Getting a little work done to his right arm. The ball keeps falling off the tee.
That's this shot. We were talking in the break, Sean, about the offensive line of Nebraska, and they get going when they see a running back give great effort and toughness, and we're starting to see that take place early in this ball game.
Seathan Carter, the tight end who's on the kickoff coverage team, will hold the ball for Bondi. Bombed one for a touchback into the wind. This is more what you would expect into that gusty breeze. A short kick caught on the run by Justice Hayes, and he's out of bounds near the 25-yard line. Here's Robert Flores.
All right, Sean, Dr. Pepper 10 conference update from the SEC. Texas A&M hosting Mississippi State. After Johnny Manziel threw a touchdown pass, Josh Robinson comes right back for the Bulldogs to tie it. This is A&M's last home game of the season, so depending on what Johnny Manziel does in the offseason, this could be his final home game.
Well, we had a very eventful offseason this past offseason. You'd have to think that that's going to be it in College Station for Johnny Manziel, but you never know. Gardner throws, catch made, Devin punches, and there's the first down for Michigan, and a big cheer goes up from this crowd. They had held the ball twice previously and had 2-3 and outs. That gets from the minus 6 yards of offense for the game now with this 13-yard pickup.
Yeah, and it starts with protection. And when he has time to work downfield, Funchess, he will get open.
He was strictly a tight end earlier in the year. Now he's a hybrid. A lot of snaps, lines up essentially as a wide receiver. Out of the eye, Fitzgerald Toussaint. And again, Nebraska on first down, playing more aggressively, crowding the line of scrimmage. Zaire Anderson made the tackle and then had a problem with his helmet, so he goes off. Well, last week, 53 yards of offense in the first quarter against one of the best defenses in the country at Michigan State. That seems like a healthy quarter compared to what they've done so far today. Another blitz. And Gardner throws, and it's almost intercepted. Intended for Jake Butt. Ciante Evans had a great shot at it. David Santos was also nearby.
This time they do a pretty good job about picking up the blitz. Toussaint does his work, forcing the guy to go around, giving Gardner time to throw, but he's throwing in a double coverage. He's got to be able to see the field, and they have to have hot routes. I'll keep going back to that. To control blitz, you need hot routes by wide receivers.
Will they bring pressure again? See how close the defenders are to that line of scrimmage. And they do bring pressure, but they don't get there. And Gardner with time completes one to Jeremy Gallen. into Nebraska territory and out of bounds at the 46. Chased out by Josh Mitchell. First catch of the day for Gardner for 16, or for Gallon, I should say.
Get him in man coverage and he run a pick route where they bring him all the way across the field. And again, with protection, Devin Gardner can deliver the football on target, and you want to get the ball into that guy's hands because he's explosive and can make things happen.
35 straight games with a catch, three shy of Braylon Edwards' school record. Tied with Jason Avant now for the second longest streak. They give it to him on the jet sweep. And another first down. Gallon on the run. Out of bounds at the 34-yard line. Corey Cooper the tackle. 12-yard gain.
That's a nice little counter right there to teams that are bringing pressure up the middle. You hit them with the jet sweep. They attack the edges in a timely manner.
That was deemed a pass. The ball went forward from Gardner to Gallon. Derek Green, the true freshman at running back now. He finds a hole. Well, Borges said they'd like to get him at least 10 carries today. Michael Rose made the tackle. Green's had just 32 carries all year.
Well, he's a bigger body than Toussaint at 240 pounds. Can pound it up in there.
Highly touted prospect out of Richmond, Virginia. ESPN had him rated the fifth best running back prospect in high school football nationally last year. He stays in the game. Joe Carriage is the fullback. Gardner stumbled as he handed the ball to Green. He got a yard, perhaps a yard and a half, and that'll be the last play of the first quarter. Avery Moss and Michael Rose credited with the tackle. Nebraska dominated for most of the first quarter, but Michigan is on the move as we head toward the second. End of one in Ann Arbor. Nebraska 10 and Michigan nothing. Welcome back to ESPN on ABC College Football, presented by K Jewelers. From breezy Ann Arbor, Michigan, end of a quarter. Nebraska leads the Wolverines 10 to nothing, but Michigan with its first sustained drive of the game into Nebraska territory. Third down and two. And Derek Green, the freshman, gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Zaire Anderson at the bottom of the pile. Aaron Curry also in there, and a decision for Brady Hoke. It would be a long field goal into the breeze now. Goes Michigan in the second quarter, and they're going to go for it on fourth down.
Well, this is where you have to be able to make an anticipated judgment of what defense they're going to be in. I'm Nebraska, I'm blitzing, so if I'm Al Borges, I have a play to counter the blitz that's coming.
They're 2 for 6 for the year on fourth down. Gardner throws on the run, has Funchess for a first down to the 18-yard line. Taken across the boundary was Funchess by Andrew Green. It's a gain of 8.
And that's exactly what they did to Roland Gardner. And you have Funchess right here, number 87 in the stack. And he's going to go ahead and move on a snap of the ball, hiding behind butt number 88, the tight end, just working to the flat and getting open.
Funchess has become a huge weapon over the last four games. He's averaged 103 receiving yards per game. Nebraska brings the blitz again, and Corey Cooper gets a piece of Derek Green at the line of scrimmage. Green managed to get ahead for a couple.
Well, here's the game plan. I mean, Nebraska knows how bad they are on first down defense. Well, the thing you counter is put those guys in running lanes to take the run away. And right now they've been pretty successful on their first down defense because of the blitz.
Michigan's first two offensive first down plays of the day, Nebraska stopped both for losses for a total of minus 11 yards. Michigan's had positive yardage on their five first down snaps since. Little screen to Jeremy Gallon trying to weave through the traffic. He's down to the 10-yard line. They'll need two more on third down. Stanley Jean Baptiste, outstanding corner, made the tackle for Nebraska.
Yeah, and getting better. He's one of those corners that a two deep, a Tampa 2 team in the NFL love because he's long, lanky, good player.
And still learning, converted wide receiver. Senior out of Miami. He's tied with Michigan's Blake Countess for the Big Ten lead in interceptions with four each. Third down and two. Jill Carriage, the fullback. Fitzgerald Toussaint back in at tailback now for Michigan. And it's Toussaint running left and back to the line, and that's all. Even with the All-American Taylor Lewan at left tackle, they could not clear a path. Michael Rose the tackle. And this time on fourth down, now within comfortable field goal range, Brady Hoke sends the kicking team out.
Yeah, I don't know why they didn't go back to the play that worked before on the third and short. Because Nebraska didn't have that covered. They're expecting run, and again, they're selling the house to stop the run. They just have too many people to block for that Michigan offensive line.
Brendan Gibbons trying a 27-yard field goal. Drew Dillio is the holder. Jareth Glanda the snapper. And the kick is good. The senior Gibbons. His 40th career field goal. Only three kickers have made more for the University of Michigan. Two of the great programs in the history of college football going head to head. Michigan number one all time with 909 wins. Nebraska's fourth. They've combined to win 16 national championships. Each has had three Heisman Trophy winners. Nebraska third in college football history in bowl appearances. They're on their way to their 50th. Only Alabama and Texas have played in more bowl games. Michigan, however, has not won a Big Ten title since 2004, and that has the folks in these parts a little glum.
Well done.
Another ball blown off the tee.
It's two great programs, though. History, tradition, two great stadiums, fan bases that are passionate.
And both fan bases wondering what they have in these teams. Michigan raced off to a 5-0 start, including a win here against Notre Dame. But they've lost two of their last three, the four overtime heartbreaker at Penn State. And then the one-sided defeat at the hands of their rivals, the Michigan State Spartans, last week. Fifth time in 6 years the Spartans have defeated the Wolverines.
So many opportunities to win that Penn State game.
Missed a couple of field goals, uncharacteristic of Brendan Gibbons. Wiles kickoff down to Kenny Bell. And he got stopped at the 27 by Anthony Capitina. Time for today's Aflac trivia question.
Aflac.
We want to know, when was the last time Michigan and Nebraska won a national championship? Showed you a moment ago, they've combined for 16. When was the last time each of them won one?
Sean, they're bringing Kellogg in, and I think that's a mistake. Ron Kellogg's coming in the ball game. Armstrong had him going, led him to 10 points, was throwing the ball, making good decisions, and you take him out and get him out of his rhythm. I do not understand that choice.
Ron Kellogg III, the fifth-year senior from Omaha, as planned, comes into the ball game. By design, they bring him in the third or fourth series of the game. Amir Abdullah tripped up, taking the handoff. Jabril Black had penetration. And it was Kellogg who was the hero, along with Jordan Westerkamp, at that last drive. He did not play a single series of the second half last week, but came in with a minute 20 to go and led them down the field and through the Hail Mary pass for the game winner as time expired. But I agree with you. You have a nice rhythm on offense. Why make the change? Abdullah carries to the 30. We asked Tim Beck that yesterday, the offensive coordinator, and he said with Armstrong, the young quarterback, they'd like to get him over the sideline and talk to him about the way the game has gone. Coach him up, but you can do that while your team's on defense.
That's fine if he's struggling. He's not struggling. Let him play.
Third down and six. Kellogg, former walk-on, paid his own way for 3 years. Grew up a huge Nebraska fan in Omaha. And is without question one of the most popular players in their program. Really acts as a coach on the field and on the sideline.
ABC College Football, presented by K Jewelers. Brought to you by Cadillac. Aflac, official partner of the Heisman Trophy. And the ultra-intuitive M-Series Smart TV from Vizio. It's beautifully simple.
And a look at some members of our armed forces proudly displaying Michigan and Nebraska colors. They root for their teams either here at home or abroad. May God bless them all, keep them out of harm's way on this Veterans Day weekend and forever. Third down and six. Ron Kellogg out of the shotgun as Nebraska leads 10-3 with 10:49 to go in the first half. There's the four-man rush. Kellogg throws, and a nice catch by Quincy Anunua right at the first down marker. Demonte Thomas, the true freshman, had the coverage, and Anunua needed all that 6'2 frame to make the catch.
Yeah, with that big body, he can lean out, box out, an outstanding catch by the layout.
Needed seven, they got seven. Kellogg is considered the better thrower of the two. Amir Abdullah stumbles up the middle for four, tripped up by Courtney Avery. As a matter of fact, that's why the coaches put him back in for that last-ditch drive when they trailed by three, a minute 20 to go last week against Northwestern. We asked him yesterday, what did you think when the coaches told you you're going back in? He said, you're joking, right? And then when he realized they were serious, he said, well, I better warm up the cannon.
Delightful young man.
Oh, he is. One of the most pleasant players we've ever talked to in our day before the game meetings. And I understand why everybody in the program raves about him. Amir Abdullah carries for three. Kellogg wants to be a coach. He admitted that heave on the Hail Mary that traveled about 55 yards in the air was as long as he could throw it. And when Westerkamp caught it, he took off in the other direction. He said, I'm claustrophobic. I didn't want to be at the bottom of a big pile. They ran toward the other end zone.
They're doing a good job of managing the game from the sidelines, giving him the proper play. After Michigan shows a defense, they change their play.
Time for Kellogg, throws a wobbler, and it's incomplete. Two receivers there, Anunua and the tight end Jake Long. And it falls incomplete. Nebraska will punt on fourth and two.
I got to believe Jake Long is in the wrong right here. He's got to create some type of space to clear that out and a catch that Anunua normally makes.
So Sam Fultz punch with the strong wind at his back. Punting in the other direction. His first one went just 29 yards. And Jeremy Gallen's back for it. Short kick. Did not take advantage of the wind, but plenty of bounce and roll. Found inside the 13-yard line. Down by Anunua. Well, do you want to answer today's Affleck trivia question, Chris? The last time Michigan and Nebraska won a national championship?
I think it was 97, I believe. I mean, I know Michigan was undefeated.
Well, they both were, and there was some controversy. It was the year before the BCS system started, so they split the polls. Lloyd Carr in Michigan won the media poll, the AP poll. Brian Griese, the quarterback. And Tom Osborne in Nebraska won in the Orange Bowl. Powerful performance against Tennessee, engineered by Scott Frost, the quarterback. Floated out into the flat. Jeremy Gallen has the toss from Devin Gardner. Zaire Anderson made the tackle.
Sean, you know a problem Michigan's having? They're running two-man routes. Why? Because they have to keep extra people in to pick up the blitz protection.
Flag on the play.
Holding. Defense number six. 10 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
Corey Cooper. The safety called for the hold.
Kind of a catch 22 for Al Borges. He understands he needs to help his backs in young center guard center combination. So what do? You have to keep extra guys in, keep a tight end in to give Gardner time, but then you're only getting two or three guys out on routes, where ideally you like to get 4 to 5.
Well, it's first and 10 for Michigan from its own 22. Tucson trying to trudge forward. He got three. Well, of course, Nebraska doesn't earn a share of the national championship in 1997. Without this play, it came to be known as the Miracle in Missouri. Scott Frost down by a touchdown, throws for Shevin Wiggins, got kicked in the air inadvertently, wink wink, we think, and Matt Davison, then a freshman, became a Nebraska hero. Hasn't paid for a beverage since that day. Now their color commentator on radio with the great Greg Sharp. What a memorable call they had of that Hail Mary pass. Ending last week's game reminded a lot of people of Matt's catch. Gardner shot down as he crossed the 26. That was Matt, who sounded like a 12-year-old at the end of that call after Greg Sharp described Westerkamp's catch.
He's a Cornhusker through and through. Also does the basketball.
Yeah, he was last night at their season opener, their beautiful new Pinnacle Bank Arena in Lincoln as they hosted Florida Gulf Coast. Matt flew here this morning. He was an outstanding basketball player in high school and played for a while on the Cornhusker basketball team when the football seasons were over. Third down and six. Another Nebraska blitz. Gardner got it off, and a diving catch made by Jeremy Gallen. So they convert on third down and six.
This is a good job of Gardner recognizing the blitz. The blitz is going to come from the top. You have Gallen, his most reliable target, working on the outcut. And again, his eyes are downfield, not bothered by the blitz, and he's able to deliver a catchable ball to the explosive Gallen.
Derek Green back into running back there in the pistol now with Gardner in front of the freshman Green. High snap off the hands of Gardner, bounced right back up to him, and Randy Gregory takes him down for a loss.
They had a high snap last week for a minus 20, and there's reminiscent of last week again. And I think what happens is the center, Glasgow, gets that ball pointed, and before the snap, he usually flattens his hand. That time he didn't, which sent the ball sailing over Gardner's head, just like last week against Michigan State.
He's a first-year starter, has played guard and now center for Michigan. Kyle Bosch, the left guard, Eric Magnuson, both freshmen. The two guards, obviously first-year starters as freshmen. Loss of 10, second and 20. And a timeout called by Michigan, leaving the Wolverines with one here in the first half. 5:41 remaining until the halftime break. 10-3, Nebraska.
I'm Robert Flores with this update. In the home of the 12th man, Sam Moeller wearing the number 12, blocks the punt for Texas A&M. Ball rose out of the end zone. That's a safety. Johnny Manziel has added a touchdown. Aggies leading 16-7 over Mississippi State.
There's our ESPN Heismanology poll this week. ESPN personnel of Heisman votes said Marcus Mariota leading the way, but that's likely to change after Oregon's loss. Devin Gardner on second and 20. Runs away from Greg McMullen, but not very far. McMullen able to track him down. Aaron Curry there as well. Some young players on that front seven for Nebraska, and they're getting better week to week. In the two deep, the 14 players, the front seven for Nebraska this week had 11 freshmen or sophomores.
I like what Al Bohr just did. Where was the pressure? It's been coming from up the middle, so that time he runs a bootleg. The coach Papuchis was all over it, where two guys took away the crossing route on a boot, forcing Gardner to tuck and run.
5 minutes to go in the half. Nebraska leading by seven, third and 19 for Michigan, and a flag down for a false start against the Wolverines.
False start. Offense number 77. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Taylor Lewan, the left tackle. Here's Shannon Spake.
Well, Sean, you know, defensive coordinator John Papuchis, sorry, it's a little cold down here. He told us yesterday he felt at times that this defense was a little bit soft, that they needed to bow up here today. Well, after they held Michigan on that third down the last series, Bo Pelini came over. He patted all his guys on the back. He said this next drive is important and stressed the word urgency.
We mentioned they've had trouble stopping the run, but not today. Devin Gardner, plenty of time. Can't find anybody open. They only rushed four this time, still nowhere to throw it. So Gardner now across the line of scrimmage, running away from Jason Ankrum, and finally gets taken down at the 28 by Leroy Alexander. John Papuchas told us yesterday the strength of the defense is the defensive backs, and they must have done a wonderful job because Gardner had all kinds of time.
Yeah, you can see everybody's taken care of, tight end down the seam. Nobody's coming back to the football to help Gardner. He does his best to not take a sack and get positive yards.
7 yard gain. That's a Michigan punt from Matt Weil into the wind. Terrell Newby. Oh, great punt. I don't know if Newby saw it. If he just tried a decoy, but look where this one's going to stop. Dennis Northfleet down there to down it. At the 3 yard line, a 69 yard punt, longest of his career for the junior Weil. .344 to go until halftime here in Ann Arbor as we look at our Pacific Life game summary. Nebraska leading 10-3, minus 5 yards of rushing. Of course, sack yardage comes off the rush total, and that bad snap didn't help the Michigan total, but still another difficult day trying to get the run going against a Nebraska team that's given up 200 yards rushing or more to 5 of their 8 opponents. Tommy Armstrong back in the game in trouble, just did get out of the end zone. He collided with the running back right after the snap. That put the play into some jeopardy, and he managed to run away from Jake Ryan to get out of the end zone.
He's going to run into his tight end who's coming to block, and that's a point saver. I mean, that won't show up in the stats, but that might be the biggest run of the game right there.
Another injured Nebraska offensive lineman. It's Jeremiah Searles playing right tackle today, ordinarily the left tackle. Senior out of Lakewood, Colorado, making his 36th career start today. And they really can't afford any more injuries. They've lost Spencer Long, their All-American candidate guard for the year with a knee injury. Jake Cotton has been starting at left guard, not available today with a knee injury. They hope to get him back. And now Bo Pelini coming out of the field. Going to check on the condition of Searles.
This is tough, and this is why linemen wear knee braces. You're going to see Searles right here, and this is Amir Abdullah getting bumped back into him, and he's going to land on the left side.
Oh, boy.
Right there. That's tough duty. I mean, Abdullah's doing a good job fighting. He's just outweighed by the heavier Clark, number 57. Nothing you can do on that from an offensive lineman, Sean. I played with plenty of them. That was a thing that they feared most. You can't see those guys falling at your legs.
Already without two offensive linemen who start. And now Searles being helped off the field. Zach Starrup has come in to play right tackle. And in a tough spot, trying to get out of the shadow of their own end zone. Abdullah crossed the line of scrimmage, and that's it. James Ross got penetration from his linebacker spot. Jake Ryan, Desmond Morgan, other linebackers in on the play. Third down and 11 for the Huskers as they're still helping Searles to the bench.
It looks like another Nebraska player down on the field. An aggressive call. Yeah, that's one guy you don't want to lose. It was an aggressive call by Greg Madison, selling out, anticipating run. He brought everybody.
Well, Abdullah is really their best offensive player. Number 6 rusher in the country, also a big receiving threat. He made a play that should not be forgotten, Chris, at the end of that game last week when they were in that desperation last drive that ended with the Hail Mary pass that won the game, but they were facing 4th down and 15. From their own 24, then he caught a 16-yard pass, a lot of it done after the catch, just did lunge to get the first down, and keep their hopes alive.
Yeah, that's just guts and determination. And he's, I would say, Sean, this is our second Nebraska game, he's the heart of this football team. Just how he plays and motivates players by his production and his play, not his words.
Good to see him walking off and does not appear to be in considerable distress. Well, the redshirt freshman, Tommy Armstrong, under center at quarterback. Imani Cross is the tailback, and there's movement along the line. Well, it's a false start.
False start. Offense number 76. Half the distance to the goal, still third down.
Brent Qualley, another veteran. He's a senior.
You know, I got to run the football here if I'm Nebraska. Why? Because I have a new right tackle in. It might still be a little bit cold. Plus the noise that the big house is bringing right now. Sometimes it's hard to hear that snap count.
Armstrong. Kind of surge forward. Get a little more working room for the punter, Sam Foltz. Michigan has just one timeout left. They let the clock run. Under 2.5 minutes to go in the half.
That was a boring call, but the right call. Just to give your punter some room because of the circumstances.
And it's interesting, Chris. I mean, the flags all indicate that the breeze is at the back of Foltz, but you spoke with Brendan Gibbons, the kicker, at practice the other day. He said it tends to swirl in the stadium, and it certainly seemed to help the last punt by Matt Wild to pin Nebraska way down here. Flags will indicate this is a punt with the wind. Not a very good one. Only to the 40, Jeremy Gowan taken down there. Well covered by Nathan Gary, the freshman. But excellent field position for Michigan after a 38-yard punt. Monday Night Football on ESPN, it's the Dolphins trying to focus on the action on the field as they head to Tampa to take on the winless Bucks. Miami and Tampa Bay, Monday Night Football, 8:25 on ESPN. Coverage begins with Monday Night Countdown at 6:30. See how the Dolphins deal. The off-the-field controversy. Devin Gardner out of the gun on first and 10 from the Nebraska 42. There's a quick slant to Jeremy Gallen, tackled immediately by Josh Mitchell. A gain to the 35, they got 7.
Another way to slow down a blitzing football team is to go to the three-step game or the quick passing game on a quick slant to Gallen. Good adjustment by Al Borges.
Gardner tried to take off running, and he's dropped for a 2-yard loss by Thad Randall and Randy Gregory.
Point of emphasis for Bo Pelini, John Papuchis, was to stay in your rush lanes for that exact reason, to take away Devin Gardner on a quarterback draw or scrambles.
Third down and 5. We approach a minute left in the half. Gardner throws too high over the middle and over the head of Devin Funches. What will Brady Hoke do on fourth down and 5 with 1:03 to go?
I'm going for it. You're at home. You got to get some type of rhythm. You have Bunches right there. If you can get him in a one-on-one situation, and you got to anticipate that Nebraska is going to blitz. If they don't blitz, you have to maintain those rush lanes so Gardner can't run for the first.
Michigan 1-for-1 on fourth down today.
I also like right here, Gallen coming in motion, shifty on route running.
The two best receivers lined up, one in front of the other to the left. Gardner flushed from the pocket, running out of time, and he's yanked down. Avery Moss, an emerging force late in his freshman year. John Papuchis' defense holds.
Well, this is Michael Rose, number 15. You see the linebacker? He's going to clear and help out, taking away where he wanted to go to Gallen off the delay route and coming up and helping his buddy Gregory, who has the speed and explosiveness that they're used to at Nebraska and their defensive line, make the play. Outstanding job by Rose of recognizing Gallen and picking him up off the pick route that Michigan tried to run.
See how Nebraska plays it. from their own 39, 53 seconds to go in the half, and all three timeouts remaining for the Cornhuskers.
I didn't know what quarterback was going in.
Ron Kellogg the third, the better thrower. So that would lead you to believe they're going to try to attack down the field with the throw game. Slings it over the middle ahead of Amir Abdullah, who's back on the field after being injured a moment ago. They're 49 seconds of game action away from the Capital One halftime report with John Saunders, Jesse Palmer. All the scores and highlights from around college football today. And in the Big Ten, another win for Minnesota. At home today against Penn State. What a great job the Gophers are doing. Pressure. Kellogg ran away from it, now takes off to the 43-yard line. Mario Ojemudia and Cam Gordon combined on the tackle.
Good decision right there by Kellogg. Did not try to force the football and got what he could get.
And Nebraska's called timeout. 37 seconds to go, facing third down and five. Still two timeouts left for the Huskers. Where the up-to-date standings reflecting Minnesota's win, they're still alive in the race for the Legends Division title. Of course, the winners of the two divisions will meet in the Big Ten championship game. Ohio State in control essentially with a two-game lead, because the first tiebreaker is head-to-head, and they have the win over Wisconsin, the only conference loss for the Badgers. Michigan State in good position in this division, but if Nebraska wins today, they host the Spartans next week, and that would be a battle to see who retains control of their own destiny in the Big Ten.
Well, everybody knows about Michigan State's defense and how well they play under Pat Narduzzi. The offense is starting to get some rhythm under Connor Cook.
On third and five, design roll for Kellogg. He throws way too high for Quincy Anunua. It was well covered by Channing Stribling, redshirt freshman, deep on the defensive backfield depth chart.
Almost thought, Sean, that Kellogg had a little bit of room to sneak through there, but he's obviously the thrower first and only runs when absolutely necessary.
Well, the coaches were joking the fastest they ever saw Ron Kellogg run was after he threw the Hail Mary pass and won the game, and then he sprinted to the other end of the field. Sam Foltz on the punt. Jeremy Gallen back for it. Flag down.
Illegal substitution. Offense, 12 players on the field. 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
Hey, it's worth a shot. Although Bo Pelini wouldn't share that opinion.
It's interesting, they got their starting tackle, number 76, Brent Qualley, in on punt protection. I don't know if I would do that if I'm down in numbers on that offensive line.
Well, you have to make sure you protect the punt, though. Foltz. Gallen picks up some blocks and gets chopped down at the 28-yard line. Mohamed Cisse. And the big block thrown by Joel Bolden, the backup linebacker. 50-yard punt and a return of 16.
Well, this is what you have to have, the head on the swivel. And
he just blocked Cisse right into the tackle, though.
Yeah, and they're cheering that. And, you know, that's just one of those things. You can't fault Bolden for taking his guy out. If anything, it's on Gallen for the poor read, but he didn't even see Bolden coming into his sights.
Cisse not seeing or saying very well right now, in all likelihood, and we don't mean to make light of it, but hopefully he'll be all right. Fans don't like the decision to take a knee. And with the struggles of the Michigan offense again today, that seems like the right thing to do. Go into the locker room and try to regroup again. Just 61 yards of offense for Michigan in the first half. They will receive the second half kickoff. Nebraska had 136 yards of offense. Defensive struggle on a windy day in Ann Arbor. Nebraska leading 10-3, 68 yards rushing, and the only touchdown of the game for Amir Abdullah. Devin Gardner, 7 out of 10 passing for Michigan for 70 yards, but they had minus 10 yards rushing. Three more sacks allowed by the Michigan offensive line.
In the last six quarters, minus 58 yards rushing.
Let's head down to the field. Here's Shannon. Well, now we're told that Shannon is not standing by with one of the coaches. Easy to understand why when you see that sea of people heading up into the tunnel. 10-3, Nebraska at the half. John and Jesse standing by with a Capital One halftime report right after these messages. We welcome you back to ESPN on ABC College Football, presented by K Jewelers. First half stats from the Big House in Ann Arbor. The number that jumps out, minus 10 rushing yards. The sack totals come off the rushing yardage, and there were three sacks for Nebraska against Devin Gardner. Also the problem with the high snap that cost Michigan. Chris, one thing we noticed at the half, the wind has really died down. It was certainly a factor in the first half. It's possible it might kick back up, but it'll be a little bit easier for both these offenses if the wind wasn't so much of an issue.
Well, I agree, but I think what Al Borges has to do, Sean, is slow down the pressure. Not only there's three sacks, but there's been some quarterback hurries on Devin Gardner. So the thing you do to counteract that is you go to the quick passing game. We saw they went to it a little bit in the second quarter when he hit Jeremy Gallen on a slant, or the quick rollout to Devin Funchess. So I look for that to get Gardner in a little bit of rhythm and take some pressure off their pass pro.
Yeah, sensing that the Michigan offensive line under siege, Nebraska did a great job with their defensive game plan coming after Devin Gardner. Down on the field, here's Shannon Spake.
Well, Sean, Brady Hoke seemed very calm coming out of the locker room. Here was my question: how do you generate offense? His answer, well, he mentioned the high snap like you did. He also said negative plays. Those are the two things he pointed out to me, and those will be things that he'll definitely be watching in this second half.
Six quarters without a touchdown for Michigan. They will get the ball first to begin the second half. Dennis Northfleet back deep for the kick from Mauro Bondi. Well, the breeze still significant enough to knock the ball off the tee again, and it should be at the back of the Floridian Bondi. Northfleet, one of the best kickoff return men in Michigan history. More than 1,400 career kickoff return yards. He's fourth in Wolverine history in kickoff return yardage.
It's amazing. Six quarters without a touchdown for a pretty good offense in Michigan, averaging 37 plus coming into this ballgame.
I wonder if some of those numbers were inflated by that beating that they gave to Indiana here when they set a number of records, including the school record for total offense in a game. It's one of the worst defenses in the country. Kickoff out of the back of the end zone. Michigan will start from the 25 after the Pacific Light game summary. And Nebraska came out aggressively, crowding the line of scrimmage, bringing extra people at Devin Gardner. And it paid off. Michigan to 60 yards of offense in the first half. Nebraska got off to a nice start, Chris. Looked like they had a little rhythm early. Their offense, carried by Amir Abdullah for a while, really fell off in the second quarter. They had 23 yards of offense in the second quarter. Fitzgerald Toussaint tripped up behind the line of scrimmage by Michael Rose. And improving the first down defense was job one for the Nebraska coaches this week, and boy, have they played better on first down today.
Yeah, and they've called a good game on first down. They've been blitzing on first down, bringing a few safeties up for extra support. But more importantly, their linebackers are getting in the right gaps compared to previous weeks. These guys are starting to get it, especially Santos and Rose.
Well, we asked Bo Pelini why 7.4 yards allowed on first down. He said, well, we've been giving up some very big plays on first down. Floater out to Toussaint. Nicely executed screen by Michigan. It's Gerald Toussaint out of bounds. They're going to mark him out back at the 50-yard line. It's a first down for the Wolverines. The longest play of the day for Michigan, 25 yards.
Just a miscommunication. Everybody's playing man. Somebody forgot to get the sneaky Toussaint out of the backfield. And a nice job by the Michigan offensive line downfield blocking on defensive backs. No easy task.
Yeah. Toussaint in trouble. Again, outstanding first down defense. This time it was Andrew Green as those defensive backs continue to crowd the line of scrimmage. He dropped it for a loss of two.
Yeah, and so in order to get by that, you have to start attacking downfield. So if they're playing three deep, which they are when they bring a safety up, what you run is four vertical. The problem Michigan has is they can't protect long enough to get four vertical. Let's see if they made some corrections at halftime so they can attack downfield with the pass.
Out of the gun, the quick throw. Caught by Jake Buck, the backup tight end. He's bumped out of bounds by Stanley Jean Baptiste. It's another first down for Michigan. They're going to mark it inside the 34-yard line.
Yeah, that's a miscommunication right here. Jean Baptiste jumps inside with the receiver going out to his area, and Bo Pelini was right in his ear as he was making his way back to the huddle. That's a miscommunication and a mental error.
19-yard gain, just the eighth catch of the season for the true freshman, Jake Butt. From Pickerington, Ohio, one of 13 true freshmen to play for Michigan this season. Play action pass for Devin Gardner. Checks it down to Toussaint. He's stopped at the 25 by Jason Ankara and Michael Rose, and a very nice opening drive here in the second half for Michigan.
And a good sign for Wolverine fans. The offensive line is doing a better job of protecting. Nebraska only brought four, but a better job.
When given time, Gardner's been effective. He's completed 10 out of 13 for the game. As you saw, 3 out of 3 to begin the second half. After a gain of 8, second and 2, back to the blitz for Nebraska, and they couldn't get Gardner down. He got away from Michael Rose, lost the football, and went out of bounds. Jason Ankara popped it out, and a break for Michigan as it crossed the boundary back near the 28-yard line.
Putting play at the spot where it went out of bounds.
Sean, they're bringing the blitz, and two guys are hitting one gap right here. They're both going to come in. You take a look. Rose is the leader, followed by Corey Cooper. And this is where Devin Gardner, you know, you don't need to make a great play all the time. Just get positive yards and put the ball away and live to play 2nd and 7 as opposed to 3rd and 4. Lucky.
Officials conferring.
To 11:53.
I'm going to add 11 seconds to the game clock.
This is the formation where they like to bring Gallen across the field to get picks, to rub him off on the 3rd and shorts.
3rd down and 5. This would be fringe field goal range into the wind for Brendan Gibbons. Pressured from behind. Gardner got it off, and it's caught for a first down. Great effort after the catch by J.U. Chesson. The freshman from St. Louis. He's down at the 19-yard line. First down, Wolverines.
And that's a big receiver that Michigan likes. They like those tall, lanky guys. And Chesson does a good job of working back to this football, eluding Jean Baptiste for the first down.
First catch of the day for Chesson. They're really a two-man receiving core out wide. Chesson's their third leading receiver for the season. That's just his 11th catch of the year. It's basically Gallen and Funchess in the passing game, and that's it. Derek Green in a running back now, the true freshman. Gardner kept it. Tried to spin through Rose. Randy Gregory there to help Michael Rose. Gained to the 16-yard line, a pickup of 3. It'll be 2nd and 7.
Remember, coming in this game, they wanted the big freshman Green to get at least 10-plus carries. And this is his area. This is where you need the tough yards when you're down in the red zone.
Michigan has just about matched its yardage total from the first half on this drive. In just more than 4 minutes, they've moved 59 yards. Looking for the tying touchdown. And in the pistol with Derek Green. Behind Gardner, the fake, the catch by Buck. Jake Buck fighting for every inch. First and goal, Michigan at the 5-yard line. He dragged Andrew Green for a while. an 11-yard gain.
Well, great effort by Butt after the catch, but it starts with the hot route. He ran a little hot route off the blitz, and Gardner recognized it and picked it up. That's another adjustment by the offense, and that's kind of the effort that you expect from Taylor Juan and a Wolverine football team.
You mentioned the wind appeared to subside for a while, but it is picked back up now. You can even hear it from time to time in the microphone. 11-yard gain. Gardner's 5 for 5 on the drive. First and goal from the 5. Gardner back in the end zone, wide open. Funchess, touchdown, Michigan. Their first in more than 6 quarters.
You're going to take away a guy down in the red zone, you want to take away number 87, who's just going to work to the flat. This is out of the bunch formation. It's designed to confuse the 3 guys covering. Nobody gets the deepest to the shortest. An easy pitch and catch for Devin Funchess and Devin Gardner.
The extra point to tie it, and Brendan Gibbons has made a school record 136 PATs in a row. Much different looking offense led by Devin Gardner here at the start of the second half. Michigan marches down the field. 75 yards, 10 plays. Gardner to Funchess, and they're tied at 10.
This telecast is available in high definition. Brought to you by Vizio.
Impressive drive to begin the second half by Michigan. They tied the game here in Ann Arbor with Nebraska 10 apiece. Devin Gardner spread it around. The touchdown pass went to Funchess, but on that drive, Butt, Toussaint, Chesson, each caught his first pass of the day from Gardner. It was 6 for 6 on the drive.
Good play calling and helped by some mental errors in coverage by the Cornhuskers.
Matt Wild picks off. Terrific job into the breeze. No chance for Kenny Bell to run it out. So it'll be Tommy Armstrong, who started the game at quarterback in the second half. He was 3 out of 7. Passing, he ran for 8 yards on 5 carries. Ron Kellogg also saw time. Trying to get Amir Abdullah going again. He breaks a tackle and has a first down. Jake Ryan couldn't pull him down to the line of scrimmage. But Jake Ryan did make the tackle. After they missed him at the line of scrimmage, it was Brennan Beyer, 97, not 47. Ryan, who whiffed at the line.
You see the great balance of Abdullah and the power. That's what he brings in great effort.
4 wide receivers now. They shifted from the pistol. Armstrong keeps. And he got 7. So a good start to this possession for Nebraska.
What they did is for their halftime adjustment is they've come out and spread the field. They have their tight end, the freshman Carter, lined up as a receiver, and they're trying to spread the defense to open up that middle of that defense so they can attack it with the run.
Tim Beck is the offensive coordinator. Abdullah bounced off a hit at the line. He's close to a first down. Desmond Morgan made the tackle after Joe Bolden couldn't make the stop at the line of scrimmage. They're inches short of the first down. Armstrong had trouble getting started, but eventually made his way across the line of scrimmage for Nebraska first down.
Good patience right there by Armstrong Jr. A lot of times people don't realize, you think a quarterback sneak, you just go ahead and dive and surge what you can get. At times you do, but if you have patience, you usually can pick it up with second effort, just like he did.
It's Nebraska offensive line playing without their two starting guards today. Has lost the tackle, Jeremiah Searles as well. Zach Stirrup, 57, still playing right tackle. He's played very little this year. The pitch to Abdullah, and he's out of bounds just short of midfield, chased out by Channing Stribling.
Again, another option. We saw two of them in the first half. The only difference is this was out of a different look. They tried to run the option, which is called a load option, where they get lead blockers out there in front. Good patience by Armstrong and Abdullah, maintaining integrity so they can get a correct pitch.
Back to the pistol now, and the play fake. Armstrong points deep, throws deep, and a diving effort, but Kenny Bell couldn't come up with it.
That's one he normally comes up with. Armstrong did a good job of directing traffic. He saw Kenny Bell working back. He's pointing deep shot. Hope the DB's looking at him, so he takes off deep.
The Bell, bothered by a groin and a shoulder, really doesn't look 100% healthy. He's not been as effective as usual. Third down and seven, midway through the third quarter, Nebraska and Michigan tied at 10. Four-man rush, but still he's in trouble and sacked back at the 36-yard line by Cam Gordon.
They run a little stun up front. Number 33, Taco Charlton, on the twist game, comes free because they did not come off and communicate on the offensive line, where Maldi stayed on his guy, did not chip off to get Charlton, who forced Armstrong out of the pocket, and they were able to secure the sack.
First sack for Michigan, a loss of 13. Gordon involved in his sixth tackle of the game. Sam Fultz punts, and a good one. Gallen watches it, bounce at the 10 and skip into the end zone. Cam Gordon and the Michigan defense fired up. They'll get the ball back at a 10-10 tie.
ABC College Football presented by K Jewelers. Brought to you by Pacific Life. For insurance, annuities, and investments, choose Pacific Life, the power to help you succeed. Ford. You could win a new F-150 and a trip for two to four BCS bowl games at Ford.com/BCS. And the new windows.
Under the command of Major Alex Garn, the University of Michigan ROTC battalion training for next week's Bold Warrior Ranger Challenge at Fort Knox in Kentucky. Wolverine Battalion is going to compete against 42 other collegiate battalions in what is considered the premier military competition for Army ROTC cadets.
Yeah, I absolutely love supporting the military at sporting events. It's awesome.
Michigan ball from its own 20. Nifty touchdown drive, their first possession of the half. This their second. Gardner under duress and sacked. There's a flag down to the backfield. Zaire Anderson, the junior from Philadelphia, with the sack. It's a holding call against Michigan. It'll be turned down by Nebraska.
They're going to bring Ciante Evans off the top from the nickel position. Michigan did not pick this up at all last year. He's going to come working one-on-one versus Toussaint. And also, he's helped by the coverage. Now, Toussaint does a decent enough job. Devin Gardner has to get rid of the football. If he has nothing there, he has to get rid of the football. But they have to go back to the quick passing game, Sean. That controls the blitz or the screens. That will control the blitz, and you can get the ball out of your hands. When you're running routes 35 yards downfield, nobody open, he's got to eat it.
Second sack of the day for Zaire Anderson, starting for just the second time this year. Second and 15, a little screen, juggling catch made by Funchess. He's off and running. And tripped up at the 38-yard line by Michael Rhodes.
Yeah, that's exactly what we just said. To slow it down, you run the screens. And this is a great effort, athletic play with the one-hander by Funchess. And he's a playmaker, the big body at 6'5 that can run.
Sophomore, he's 235-pounder out of Farmington Hills, Michigan. Had seven catches for 151 yards in their win against Minnesota. Today, four receptions for 49 yards. Derek Green is the tailback now, behind Joe Carriage, the fullback. Following Carriage, he spins forward for about four. David Santos, the stop for Nebraska.
That's a big load.
I don't know, Santos is shaking his head. Well, I better bring it next time. I need a neck roll if I'm going to tackle 240. Good job of getting him down. Take a shot deep if they go blitz.
They rush four. Trouble with the snap by Gardner, and there is Randy Gregory to take him down. Back at the 36.
Okay, even though it's a mistake by Gardner, you do not put a running back on the most explosive pass rusher of Nebraska. You don't put the freshman on Gregory. He has to make that call, the quarterback, which side of protection. See everybody sliding to the left. That means Green has the furthest outside rusher, does not do the job, and Gregory's there to get the sack.
In the words of Bo Pelini, Randy Gregory is special, sophomore. 3.5 sacks entering today's action. John Papuja said he had three other sacks that were wiped out due to penalties. 5 sacks today for the Huskers. Time for Gardner. Zings one. Incomplete behind his intended receiver. It was Funchess. It's Stanley Jean Baptiste in coverage.
Nebraska goes conservative, only bring in 4. Funchess is open. That's a nice route. The ball behind. Baptiste says, maybe I missed a chance at that possible pick 6.
Matt Wild a punt. Jordan Westerkamp, who was not in action for a while, apparently has recovered from whatever was ailing him. Short, wobbly kick. Takes a good bounce for Michigan. Joe Bolden downs it at the 24-yard line. 4:13 to go, third quarter. Tied at 10. The punt went 40 yards. With his win last week in Texas, Jimmy Johnson has regained the lead in the chase standings. Only 2 races left. Matt Kenseth trailing by only 7 points. It's been a seesaw battle between JJ and Matt, and it continues this week in the desert, the chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup at Phoenix, presented by Quicken Loans tomorrow at 2 Eastern. Jimmy Johnson shouldn't be too comfortable. In each of the last 3 years, the driver who was leading with 2 races left in the chase didn't win the championship, including JJ himself last year.
Well, Shannon will be with the Kenseth camp on Tuesday, spending the day.
First down, Nebraska, tied at 10. Amir Abdullah ahead for 2, yanked down by James Ross, the third. Nebraska's done very little with the ball since the first quarter when the Huskers scored all 10 of their points.
They have the win, so you'd like to see him maybe take a shot downfield or work the perimeter a little bit to spread out. Here they go, those 4 wides, and they've done that to run the football up the middle to spread Michigan's D out.
Only 12 passes, perhaps being careful with Armstrong. He's thrown 6 interceptions in the last 2 games. Armstrong found some running room after a couple of collisions, and Brennan Beyer made the tackle just across the 30. It'll be third down and 4 for Nebraska.
And one problem Nebraska has is that they don't have an active tight end in the passing game.
Neither team has committed a turnover. It might come down to which team takes it away, which team makes the big mistake. The total offense almost dead even now. 153 for Nebraska, 151 for Michigan. 3 minutes to go in the third. Armstrong, a late pitch and a good catch by Taylor Nerby, but he's down for a loss. James Ross, the third, dropped him.
Black did a great job of forcing the pitch in almost a costly error, but he made a strong pitch, but it took so long to develop. James Ross the third, a very instinctive linebacker out there to seal the deal to make it 4th down.
Sam Fultz to punt. Jeremy Gallen back for it. And it's down by the Huskers at the 34. Nathan Gary downed it. Notre Dame and Pittsburgh tonight on ABC, presented by the new windows. It's at 8 o'clock from Pittsburgh. So long rivalry. I didn't realize tonight being the 69th meeting, Chris, that Notre Dame played only four other opponents more frequently than they played the Pittsburgh Panthers, coached by Paul Chryst.
Yeah, two proud traditions there. We're talking about a tradition-filled game with Nebraska, Michigan, Notre Dame, Pittsburgh. Thank you.
Devin Gardner starts this possession under center. And he hands it off. Devin punches on an end around. Bangs off the hip. And they're going to spot him out of bounds at the 39. It's a gain of five on first down for Michigan.
Nice job of Al Borges getting the playmakers the ball in their hands any way he can via the pass, the run, the screen. Two of the most explosive playmakers on Michigan are Gallen and Funchess.
Michigan's best win, that victory over Notre Dame. They rose all the way up to number 11 in the polls after they beat the Irish. Dropped in the polls after that narrow win against Akron. They're unranked now at 6-2. Nebraska also unranked at 6-2 overall. A blitz, and it's effective again. Corey Cooper drops Derek Green for a loss, and we send you back to Robert Flores.
Hi, Sean. AT&T All-America Player of the Week nominee, Auburn quarterback Nick Marshall, 214 yards on the ground. Two touchdowns. He passed for another as Auburn beat up Tennessee 55-23. Visit ESPNAllAmerica.com. Sean, in that game, Auburn threw it just nine times.
Watch the beginning of that. They came out throwing. They threw a pass on their first three plays of the game. J.U. Chesson went in motion and set to the left. Here comes another Nebraska blitz. Gardner backpedaling, and it's incomplete. Intended for Jeremy Gallen. Well covered by Stanley Jean Baptiste. And I don't know, Chris, if you're Nebraska, why you would go it down on defense without blitzing, because every time they do, it seems, it just throws this Michigan offense out of whack.
Yeah, and I think why you don't, because you might be a little nervous about giving up the big play, but I love the way Jean Baptiste navigated through the traffic. They tried to throw a pick there for Gallen on the crossing route, which we've seen all night. And he was able to navigate his way through to get tight coverage to force the incomplete.
Matt Weil on the punt. Another low line drive. Going to be down to the 22-yard line by Delonte Hollowell. 41-yard punt. Here's a look at this week's BCS standings, brought to you by Allstate. Of course, a big game tonight for Alabama. And Oregon is going to slide after the loss at Stanford. It'll be interesting to see how it shakes out with Ohio State on a bye week. Ohio State, Stanford, Baylor all jockeying for position right out of those crucial top two spots.
Yeah, Baylor with an impressive win over Bob Stoops and the Oklahoma Sooners.
The big game Bob hasn't been as much big game Bob here in recent years at Oklahoma. Tommy Armstrong with 50 seconds to go in the third quarter. Trying to get this offense moving again. Has an open receiver. Quincy Anunua lost the football. And apparently they're going to roll down a fumble. The Nebraska sideline thought Anunua was down. Chris Wormley recovered for Michigan, and undoubtedly this will get an extra look in the replay booth.
Fumble recovered by Michigan.
That's a fumble. Cam Gordon knocked it out while Anunua was still up.
Yeah, good things happen when you run the football. You're the second guy in. You attack the football. Cam Gordon coming with a wrap-up tackle as opposed to the bump or leading with the shoulder is able to strip it out of there.
Chris Wormley, a freshman with the recovery. Clearly a fumble. First turnover of the game for either team. First down from the 33. Gardner with a four-man rush. Goes for single coverage for Gallen, incomplete with Josh Mitchell. Limping away after he had the coverage.
I like the call by Michigan to go deep on first down after a turnover. But you know, a smart football team and a good defensive coordinator understands that's a trend that a lot of people like to do it. And line up and able to play man-to-man, and they did not blitz that time, Sean. They had man-to-man coverage with safety help. Good job by JP, John Papuchis.
And see this young defense getting better. Gardner in all kinds of traffic. They just overwhelmed that offensive line. Siante Evans tried to pull it away from Gardner, and that's a big loss. Back to the 36-yard line. If I was Nebraska, Chris, I would think about a timeout here.
Yeah, and you look at right because of the win, absolutely. And Siante Evans coming off the corner in a nickel blitz. They got a little bit of a trend going right now on an incomplete pass in the first down. Michigan's going to the run, and so Nebraska's countering the blitz to take away the run.
Well, that's the reason I mentioned the timeout. You might want to force a long field goal into the wind, but Bo Pelini, I think, deciding it's going to be a 52-yard field goal from here in either direction, so that probably doesn't matter as much right now. Entertaining Big Ten battle between these two proud football programs. 10-10 the score. We head to the fourth quarter at the Big House. Welcome back to ESPN on ABC College Football, presented by K Jewelers. From the Big House, Michigan Stadium in Ann Arbor, the Michigan offense held to 60 yards in the first half, had 91 in their first touchdown in seven quarters. In the third quarter, despite the fact that they have minus 18 yards rushing for the game, they're in a 10-10 tie. Third down and 12 at the Nebraska 35. Gardner running out of time, just throws it away, up for grabs, and almost intercepted by Josh Mitchell. Randy Gregory had Gardner in his grasp. Josh Mitchell almost picked it off. Jeremy Gallen, the intended receiver. Gardner's lucky to get away with that.
It's a good job of design by Nebraska's defense, lining Gregory up as a linebacker and bringing him on the blitz. In his closing speed, the explosive defensive lineman for Nebraska forces the bad throw. That's not bad protection right there. He had time to throw that football, just didn't have anybody open.
There's Matt Weil, who's usually the punter. He comes on to try long field goals, and this will be a 52-yard try with the wind. He mentioned the possibility of Nebraska calling timeouts to try to force it into the wind. The wind at his back didn't matter. He had a low snap hook wide left. We can relate to that. And the defense, terrific. And they really have been all day long for Bo Pelini. When you think back to the late sequences in that game last week at home in Lincoln against Northwestern, Armstrong threw an interception with 2:25 to go in a tie game that Northwestern ran back to the 7-yard line. And the Nebraska defense held and forced a field goal, so they were within three when they got the ball back and wound up winning the game on that Hail Mary pass. Bobby Armstrong, one of the few deep throws today, and it's open. Quincy Anunua. Taken down by Channon Stribling at the Michigan 42-yard line. It's 23 yards.
How about showing confidence in Anunua? Good protection up front. Fumbled the last catch he caught. This time they come right back to him to get his confidence back up.
Abdullah got flattened after a gain of one. Splattered by Joe Bolden.
Greg Madison likes what Joe Bolden's bringing, getting better. Young player, sophomore out of Coleraine in Cincinnati. Excellent football school.
Jake Ryan showing blitz from Armstrong's right. He's just 5 out of 10 passing for 75 yards. Throws quickly, far sideline, Anunua out of bounds. They'll keep the clock running. We're under 14 minutes to go. Raymond Taylor made the tackle for the Wolverines.
Here we go, third down now. They've been a little conservative, but right now he's heating up a little bit. They might have a little bit more confidence. So you're gonna maybe work the right side and sometime a combination route down here with these two receivers.
Conceivable it's four down territory. On third and four. Armstrong, the fake, throws a wobbler, and his receiver, Brendan Riley, was falling down. Interesting target on such a big play. A freshman who has just one catch all year and is deep on the depth chart.
Yeah, this is not the place to go with the football. Brendan Riley, as you said, Sean, hasn't played much all year, and it's good coverage by Taylor. But why not go to Kenny Bell? Why not go to Anunua? Set up a little pick route. Yeah, go to that young
good
guy.
Pass receiver. They're going to punt on fourth down and four from the Michigan 36. Sam Foltz. Too far. Josh Mitchell down there trying to down it, but it was in the middle of the end zone. So it'll come out to the 20 after a timeout. This week, ESPN's Monday Night Football brings you Miami at Tampa Bay, 8:25 on ESPN. Two teams in dire need of something good to happen. Those with off-the-field issues, the Bucs are winless. Rumors swirling about their coach's future. Of course, the Dolphins have a mess involving Vici Incognito and Jonathan Martin. 10-10 the score here. Fourth quarter. Michigan on first down from its own 20 gets nothing. Aaron Curry stuffs Fitzgerald Toussaint, and Michigan still stuck on minus 18 yards rushing for the game.
And again, they're going right with the blitz. They're ahead of Al Borges right now as far as when blitzing, when not to blitz.
Why wouldn't you keep doing it? Michigan really hasn't had an answer for it all day long. Beleaguered offensive line and a quarterback that's been taking a pounding week to week. Devin Gardner throws it out in the flat to the fullback Joe Carriage. Knocked out of bounds. It looks like he has the first down. Zaire Anderson made the tackle. And it is a first down for Michigan. That's the first touch of the season for the sophomore Carriage, the fullback who didn't have a rush or reception entering today's game.
And it was all set up by the work of Funchess, picking off Zaire Anderson, who was trying to get out there in coverage. Get everybody involved in the offense.
Toussaint. Ahead 4-3. David Santos the tackle. Here's Robert Flores.
Sean, we'd like to welcome those of you who have been watching Wisconsin and BYU on ESPN. The Badgers' James White has a couple of touchdown runs. This one makes it 27-10. He also has 113 yards rushing. 27-10 Wisconsin at home.
Good-looking Badger team. Two losses on the year, hoping to win out and merit consideration for an at-large BCS bowl bid if they don't win the Big Ten. That's a long shot, trailing Ohio State in their division. Carriage just upended for a loss of one by Ciante Evans.
Discipline. Discipline by Gregory. Discipline by Evans. Not going for any type of play action. Gregory doesn't get sucked inside. Does his job forcing the throw. Ciante Evans does not chase and makes an open field tackle.
Evans a real leader of that defense. Gregory a force up front. Evans matched up for a lot of the day with Jeremy Gallen. He's done a very good job on the second leading receiver in the Big Ten. Gallen 49 yards receiving. He averages 112 a game. Third down and eight. Another Nebraska blitz. Look out. Gardner got away for a moment. Gregory says no you don't. Bo Pelini said yesterday Gregory's going to be special. He is special.
Already. Yeah, and they line him up at linebacker to match him up with Toussaint. And frankly, it's no match. And you see right here, they slide the protection again. And Toussaint comes to chip him. And he doesn't get any help from Schofield, who could have helped Toussaint out by getting a body on him. So he avoided two to get the sack.
Matt Wild a punt. Second sack for Gregory, six for Nebraska. Michigan's given up 13 now in two games. Lester can't muff the punt. You can't advance it, but Michigan's going to get the ball at the 26-yard line. Dennis Norfleet picked it up on the run, but it's a muff punt which cannot be advanced, but Michigan will have it at the Nebraska 26. Last week's hero, Western Camp, who caught the Hail Mary.
Recovered by the...
Muffs the punt with 10 minutes to go, and that could be a disaster for Nebraska.
Well, you said it. In this ball game, which has been relatively clean as far as turnovers, the first team that turns it over could be the victim, and he just took his eye off at the last second, and a good job, athletic move of Norfleet picking up a bouncing ball on the run. Now can Michigan capitalize? This is where Nebraska's defense has to challenge, and I'm looking for Nebraska's defense to bring the house to try to get them out of field goal position.
They're in field goal range now. Would likely be Gibbons if they had to kick it from right here for about a 43-yarder, the regular field goal kicker. Derek Green's the tailback. Nebraska up around the line. He tries to get outside. He got tunneled after a gain of one, perhaps a yard and a half. Zaire Anderson and Corey Cooper there, and we're under 10 minutes to go.
And they did, Sean. They're coming with that linebacker safety blitz. The linebacker first through the hole, the safety coming second, with Corey Cooper forcing the ball outside. That's their first down blitz.
Two Nebraska turnovers late in the game. The defense covered up. Anun was fumbled. And they get Westerkamp off the hook. Here's Green. Stacked up for a loss of a couple. And the Boo Birds are out in earnest, and it's loud when there's more than 112,000 folks booing.
It's the same thing, and they just ran it to the other side. Corey Cooper sitting in the hole on block, and you can't get mad at the blockers because there's not enough blockers to block all those guys. You have to hit them off the play action out for that look.
Big third down and 11 here. Be about a 44-yard field goal for Gibbons. His career long's 52.
See Gregory, number 44, lined up as a linebacker. They've had trouble handling him from that position.
Very passive rush by Nebraska. All times to back off. Gardner trying to run through them. And he's forced across the boundary by Stanley Jean Baptiste. So the defense holds, covers up for that muff by Westerkamp. The boos rain down. 112,204 here today. It is the 250th consecutive home game of the Big House, which Michigan has drawn more than 100,000 fans. And here's Gibbons. A 40-yard try. He's one for one today from 27 yards. He needs it to slice it, hit the upright and went through. And Michigan has the lead for the first time today with 8:08 to go. Brandon Gibbons gives the Wolverines the lead by just that much.
ABC College Football presented by K Jewelers. K Jewelers, the number one jewelry store in America. Every kiss begins with K. Jaguar. See the new model year lineup at jaguarusa.com. And Carhartt. Outwork them all.
Every kiss begins with K. Brendan Gibbons just kissed one off the upright and threw for Michigan. Give the Wolverines a three-point lead, their first lead of the game, 8:08 to go. So can Nebraska pull one out in the fourth quarter for the second week in a row in dramatic fashion? Matt Wild to kick off. Kenny Bell back deep with Alonzo Moore. You'll come out to the 25. We send you down to Shannon Spake.
Well, Sean, Nebraska offensive coordinator, I told you at the beginning of the game, Tim Beck, he said that they were limping into this game. Well, that limp has certainly gotten a little worse here today. Jeremiah Searle's left tackle, he got injured at the end of the first half. He is in street clothes, sitting down on the bench, walking around the sideline, but he is apparently not playing anymore in this game. Also, I've been keeping my eye on Kenny Bell. He came into this game with a groin injury. He's been spending a lot of time on the stationary bike, trying to keep that area warmed up, but you could certainly see that he's favoring it.
And they stick with Tommy Armstrong. or at least one more series if it gets the desperation throw time at the end of the game, but you'd probably see Ron Kellogg. Play fake to Abdullah. Over the middle and incomplete. Too far ahead of Seathan Carter, running with Joe Bolden, the linebacker.
Well, he had him too. He just had to put a little air under that. Should have threw the changeup when he threw the fastball. Little line drive, because he was behind Bolden and there was no safety help behind him.
Tonight here on ABC, the Fighting Irish and the Pittsburgh Panthers. 8 minutes to go in Ann Arbor. Vanunua out of bounds. A little bit short of the first down, chased out by Ramon Taylor. You wonder with hindsight if Vanunua might have made a better effort to get another yard and move the chains. Now they're in a very important third and short.
Last time they were in this position, they did a quarterback sneak, and Armstrong was very patient, sliding off to his right.
And that patchwork line creates some ground for Armstrong. It looks like he got it. Needed just get to the 35, and he did. For Nebraska, first down midway through the fourth quarter.
It's a good sign when you see number 62 in your screen there, Cole Pensick. He was 3 yards downfield. Well, that's the center. So if he gets that kind of surge, you're hoping your quarterback can.
The option. A high pitch. Good catch by Abdullah. Down just short of a first down, a pickup of 9. James Ross III made the tackle for the Wolverines.
This is a great effort by James Ross III. Why? Because he's going to get chopped down. You see right there, he gets knocked on his feet, but he does not stay down, hustles, gets up, and makes a tackle downfield. That's Michigan football and Michigan defense.
Second and short, they put the fullback C.J. Zimmer in the game. He blocked Cam Gordon just long enough to help Abdullah get the first down. Gordon made the tackle, bouncing off the block of the fullback. The line of scrimmage for the Nebraska 48 and the first down for the Cornhuskers.
The clock ticks away, both teams with all three timeouts. Nebraska in no hurry, want to get in the right play for their young quarterback.
And Abdullah approaching another 100-yard game. He gets there, it'll be his 8th and 9 games this year. That's illegal motion. Ron Abdullah. Flag thrown by John O'Neill, the referee. It'll be the 5th penalty of the day against Nebraska. Michigan has been flagged twice.
Illegal motion. Offense number 8. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
On 1st and 15, Armstrong pulls it down, has some running room. And a nice tackle by James Ross III. You talk about shedding a block. He did a great job of it. It looked like he was going to be a bigger gainer for Armstrong.
Yeah, he shed the block of number 2 more. And quite frankly, Armstrong missed the read. He cut right into Ross. Ross, 2 big plays downfield and open field.
Gain of 6, 2nd and 9. Nebraska at its own 49. Armstrong wanted to throw it deep. Has a first down to Kenny Bell. Just his 2nd catch of the game. Ramon Taylor, the tackle at the Michigan 39, a 12-yard pickup.
Here's the growth of a young quarterback. You see all that green space he had to run, but he trusts his receiver, Kenny Bell, the veteran, to get open, and he delivers the strike under pressure.
113 career catches now for Kenny Bell, 5th in Nebraska history. Out of the pistol. Abdullah stacked up. Lost a half yard. Frank Clark, Taco Charlton there. And Ramon Taylor up from the secondary. 5 minutes to go. Michigan leading Nebraska 13-10. Pat Smith's long field goal this year is 45. Bear in mind again, they're going into that stiff wind. He had to pitch it to Abdullah. Dives ahead for a couple with the defense closing in. Joe Bolden was there. They're not in field goal range now. And here's a ginormous third down. Third down and nine as we approach 4 minutes to go in Ann Arbor. Now Nunwa, short of the first down, gang tackled. Desmond Morgan, Channing Stribling, Josh Furman all there. Now a decision for Bo Pelini. It would be a 48-yarder into the wind. A long attempt of the year for Smith is 48 yards. That was last week, and he hit the right upright against Northwestern. They're going to go for it on fourth and two.
Absolute right call, Sean. Into the wind, plus you have three timeouts left.
Yeah, if you don't get it, play defense and use the timeouts. Awkward snap, no flags down, and it's a first down to Bell, who escapes the tackle. Inside the 10, Birch gives him a block, and he's inside the 5-yard line. Boy, there was some awkward movement along that line of scrimmage, but there weren't any flags. 26-yard gain and a first down.
How about this throw from the far hash to the sidelines? A dart to Kenny Bell, and this is the Kenny Bell we're used to seeing. You see soft coverage out there. Kenny Bell with the spin move, able to get downfield with Birch hustling to make a play for his teammate. Gutsy throw, confident throw. That's growth in Armstrong Jr.
First and goal, Nebraska. Amir Abdullah gets nothing. Well, let's go back to the previous play, Chris, and see if there should have been an infraction on either team. Well, definitely people moving before the snap, but apparently they didn't cross into the neutral zone from the defensive side, and apparently none of the Cornhuskers moved before that snap by Cole Pensick. The fade for Birch. And again, you wonder about the selection of receiver, Chris. Earlier, a big down, they went to Brandon Riley as one catch all year. Here's Brandon Riley, here's Sam Birch, who starts the day with five catches. I guess they figure Bell and Anunua are going to see a lot of coverage, so you're more likely to get a favorable matchup with the receiver with less of a resume.
Yeah, they tried to run the pick play with Anunua as the decoy or the picker.
Huge play, third and goal from the 5. 14th play of the drive. They started from their own 25. Now they're here. Armstrong, forward pass. That's legal. Touchdown, Abdullah. He was behind the line of scrimmage. It was intended to be an option. It turned out to be a forward pass. And it's a go-ahead touchdown for Nebraska with 2:03 to go.
It's all about the patience of the young Armstrong. Waiting for the pitch, Frank Clark commits. And Abdullah is there, securing a catch with good hands. And again, once he gets around that goal line, he knows how to finish.
One of the great players in the country, Amir Abdullah. Now a very important extra point to make it a 4-point lead. And the kick is good by Pat Smith, senior transfer from Western Illinois. Not a Hail Mary, but it's late fourth quarter heroics again by the Nebraska offense. Abdullah caps a 6:05 drive. Just two races left in the chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup Championship. Tomorrow they're in Phoenix at 2 Eastern time on ESPN, presented by Quicken Loans. Jimmy Johnson, the 7-point lead over Matt Kenseth.
I think
Kevin
Maddie,
Harvick, 40 yeah. points behind.
I think Maddie K won there in Phoenix earlier in the year.
Maddie K. All right.
I'm sure they called.
Shannon says Carl Edwards won there earlier in the year, and I'm certainly going to go with her.
Yeah,
huge
exactly.
kickoff here from Oro Bondi. He's got a big leg. They love the touchback. It's into the wind. I'll tell you what, these kickers have been impressive today. Dennis Northfleet downs it, so Michigan will start at the 25. They need to go 75. A field goal does no good. Here's today's Good Hands play brought to you by Allstate.
Well, just the poise right here of Armstrong. Alonzo Moore, number two, out there. Blocky Nod Taylor executed. Abdullah not panicking, catching the ball first, then scoring. Well done all the way around. Now, when Michigan scored, Sean, he spread the ball around to different receivers. Let's see if they do that in this possession. Devin
Gardner. With an interesting formation, three receivers in a line to the right of Gardner. And only a four-man rush. They give Gardner time. It's a 10-yard completion to Funches. And a first down. All three timeouts left for Michigan. It'll be interesting to see how Nebraska plays it. They've had great success pressuring all day long.
Yeah, it's a good route right here and a good design by Al Borges because it makes it very difficult to do the matchup coverage that Nebraska likes to do with that line of receivers running at you.
First and 10. They rush five. Gardner out in the flat for Funches. And a good tackle by Andrew Green. And Funches did not get out of bounds, so the clock runs. It'll go under a minute and a half to go. Michigan at the 42-yard line.
Good protection so far for the Wolverine offensive line.
They need a touchdown. They've scored one in almost eight full quarters now. None last week, one today. Pressure right up the middle. Gardner sidestepping. Lobs one downfield for Funches, incomplete. Andrew Green in coverage. Third down and four, Michigan.
Boy, risky call right there by John Papuchis and Bo Bellini. Playing tight man-to-man, trusting that your blitz is going to get there. Now, how do you call this? I'm not going to blitz right here. I don't want to give a risk of the first down or a big play. I'm going to play it a little bit safe, play a matchup zone, and only bring four.
Three out of 14 on third down. And a timeout.
Charge full timeout to Nebraska. They're first.
Nebraska called it. 1:13 to go. It's already been an entertaining day of college football on ABC today. Perhaps more of the same tonight, 8 Eastern time. Notre Dame and Pittsburgh from Heinz Field, presented by the new windows. Nebraska leads 17-13 after a terrific drive engineered by Tommy Armstrong. Put the Huskers back on top. Now third down and four for Michigan from their own 42, 1:13 to go.
There's a stack.
Gardner rolls toward it. Forced back the other way. Gregory trying to contain. Now he attacks Gardner and takes him down. Behind the line of scrimmage, Randy Gregory is a man.
Sean, they went for the stack route. That's where Gardner wanted to go. You're lining up your two best wide receivers to run some type of delay or pick with Gallen and Funches. They take it away with the matchup coverage downfield, forcing Gardner to tuck and run. Then you have Randy Gardner staying disciplined on the backside, making sure that Gardner does not get outside of him, and a great speed at 6'6" is able to seal the deal.
Well, this defense has been heavily criticized. You can see this young group growing before your eyes today, taking advantage of that very shaky Michigan offensive line and a quarterback whose confidence has probably been shaken. Three sacks for Gregory today, seven for Nebraska. The coaches said Siante Evans could do a job on Gallen. Gallen hasn't had a catch in this half, one of the best receivers in the country. Siante Evans moved out to cover him on the last play. So here's the game in all likelihood. 1:02 to go. Fourth down and five, Michigan.
That's Funches. He was circled.
Here comes the pressure. Gardner throws through the hands of Drew Dillio. And Nebraska will take over on downs. Josh Mitchell had the coverage.
Well, the protection's solid. The play call is solid. It's just a dropped pass. The throw is solid.
And again, you go back to the coaching too, because these last couple of plays with those bunch formations, the Nebraska players knew exactly what their responsibility was as those receivers separated coming across the line of scrimmage. Michigan has two timeouts. But if Nebraska just hangs on to the football here, they're going to get a huge win. Abdullah wants to stay in bounds, protects the football, and is down inbounds.
Amir Abdullah
with a 5-yard gain. He's over 100 yards for the eighth time in 9 games. John Papucci is still coaching up that defense. He deserves a game ball today. What a plan. Took advantage of that shaky Michigan offensive line all day long. Here's the game summary. Nebraska leading 17-13, led 10-0. Saw the lead disappear as Michigan scored 13 unanswered points. Then Armstrong engineered a 14-play, 75-yard drive. They held the ball for 6 minutes and 5 seconds. Armstrong had only 6 completions for the game. He went 5 out of 6 on that drive, including hitting his last 5, the touchdown to Abdullah. And the Michigan is 52 seconds away now from its first home loss under Brady Hoke. Ooh, Abdullah rocked by James Ross III. Michigan will use his last timeout. The last loss for Michigan here was in November of 2010 against Wisconsin.
I was actually at that game. Sean, to me, this is a replay of last week against Michigan State. Just you look at the numbers, 7 sacks, 44 yards, and minus 21 yards rushing. Everybody knows the sacks still, but when you look at a Michigan game, you were to tell me early in the year that in a 2-game stretch, the Wolverines would have minus 69 yards rushing in those 2 games, that's not a Michigan team that I recognize, quite frankly.
And the fans here don't as well. You're wondering, by the way, that the longest active home winning streak in FBS belongs to Northern Illinois. It doesn't count a loss in a game they played in Chicago. Tommy Armstrong just wanted to hang on the ball. Michigan cannot stop it. We wondered about Bo Pelini's team. Their wins in the Big Ten, the 3 prior today, were against teams that hadn't won a game this year in the league. Northwestern, Purdue, and Illinois, a combined 0-13 in conference, started today. This is an impressive win. Even though Michigan's scuffling, you come here to the Big House and win, it's impressive.
And they will get tested next week against Mark D'Antonio and Sparty.
Nebraska retains control of its own destiny. In the Legends Division of the Big Ten, they'll take on Michigan State and Lincoln next Saturday. The battle for control of the destiny. Right now, Michigan's undefeated in conference play, but if Nebraska beats them, they'd have the win head-to-head and have the upper hand in the Legends Division. For the 2nd week in a row, dramatic late fourth quarter rally for Nebraska. Amir Abdullah, the winning touchdown, and here's Shannon.
Coach Pelini, congratulations. I just saw you talk to Brady Hoke. What did you say to him just now?
Just between he and I, he's a class act, and just wish him luck the rest of the way, and proud of my football team. You know, we were beat up. We got a lot of guys hurt. We were shorthanded, and our guys kept fighting. It was a heck of a defensive effort, and really that was a great class drive by our offense, and proud of our guys. It's been a long time since Michigan lost in this place.
What is it like as a coach to watch your team put together a drive like you did offensively when you went for it on 4th down and then got the touchdown?
Yeah, it just showed the character that they have, you know. You know, we obviously, Westy dropped that punt, and our defense stood up and gave us a chance. And our offense, you know, we talked about all week about picking each other up. They just keep playing and play every down and play to the end. And they did that today, and I'm proud of this group.
When you look at the rest of the season and you look at the defensive performance tonight, how do they compare? How do they do this evening?
No, we're getting better. I've said that. I really like what this team's going to be down the line. And we're still a work in progress, but I'll take this win. It'll be a... I'm proud of this group.
Thanks, Coach. Congratulations. Amir Abdullah also here. Great game for you today. 2 touchdowns. What do you think the emotions are going to be in that locker room right now? You have the Hail Mary last week and now this win.
It's a great win. You know, anytime you get a Big Ten win, it's huge. So the emotion is going to be high. But, you know, we got a long road ahead of us. You know, we got to stay even keel. we can't drink the Kool-Aid. You know, we got to come back next week and get back to work.
How would you describe the way you guys came out in the second half?
Just physical, you know, just staying the course. You know, Michigan's defense, I tapped their head off to them. They played an outstanding second half, really from the second quarter to the end of the game, you know, but we stayed the course and stayed consistent in our game plan, and, you know, eventually it panned out for us.
Tell me about the game-winning touchdown. What goes through your mind when that's through the air coming your way?
You know, I look up to Kobe Bryant a lot, and he always says, anytime the game's on the line, you want the ball in your hand. You know, I trust myself more than anything, like Kobe says, and I'm glad the coaches trust me so much to put the ball in my hand to win the game. And, you know, I got to tip my hat to Alonzo Moore, man. He had a great block right there, and that wouldn't have went for a touchdown if he didn't block.
Congratulations. You enjoyed this one.
Thank you.
Guys?
He constantly gives praise to his wide receivers for the blocking job they do, and in that case, it was deserved praise for Alonzo Moore. Huge win for Nebraska, as we mentioned. One game behind Michigan State, but Sparty comes to Lincoln next Saturday, and the winner of that one will have the hammer in the Legends Division with an eye toward playing in the Big Ten Championship game. They're 5-0 under Tommy Armstrong. We asked Bo Pelini yesterday, is Taylor Martinez coming back? He said, I have no idea, but you didn't get the sense that the Nebraska people were that concerned. And Armstrong, poised all day, led that nifty drive to win it. The defense, outstanding, 7 sacks. Nebraska wins 17-13, Notre Dame in Pittsburgh tonight. But now back to the studio for the postgame report.